not to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedom.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. I want to share with you guys something that I'm going to put to the test. You know, in my pursuit of the truth in all areas, there's many questions that are left unanswered, like why is society so dumbed down? And we think, you know, as far as truthers and activists, that maybe it's because of the fluoride, and maybe it's because of the toxins and the GMOs, and I'm sure that's a part of it. But it's been mentioned to me several times in my life that cutting hair is very relative to your abilities, things you can't quite put your finger on, a sixth sense, you may say, a spirituality. So anyway, I've been doing some looking around, and it seems that our government knew this. Back in the Vietnam era, Native Americans were used for tracking because they excelled at it beyond anything any of our military could do, their natural ability. So they were scouted and brought into the military and given military haircuts. At that time, they lost all their ability to track. And so then the government did testing. They paired men, two by two, that had basically the same skill set or test level achieved as far as their tracking ability and whatnot. And they would cut one of the men's hairs and leave the other one uncut. And every time, the person who had had their hair cut lost their abilities to track, to sense things coming at them, even while they were sleeping. Those that had their hair were able to sense an enemy far away before it ever got near them and wake and get themselves to safety. And, you know, in my life, I've just felt like for quite a while there's really something missing. And my energy level is not what it should be. And although I feel like I can see things that the average American or average human can't see, this still isn't enough. I need to cross a boundary here. And quite honestly, I'm getting really close to giving up a lot of the things that I do now as far as activism, because I don't see them being effective. But anyway, on this, I have decided to not cut my hair. And I'm going to give you guys feedback. Now, it's been a couple months since I did cut my hair. So it's still fairly short, but I did start growing the beard, and I'm going to just let that go. I'm not going to cut it at all. Now, I'm not one that likes to pay for haircuts, you know? I don't. So you would have thought that I would have automatically just always had long hair, but I've never had long hair because, well, society doesn't like long hair. That makes you a dirty hippie. Right? That makes you all kind of things society says you are. Unless, of course, you're a female, and then, you know, we have a different opinion about long hair. But as far as men go, you know, when you see somebody walking along with long hair braided, you think they're less than you. And quite honestly, those that I've interacted with are much more peaceful. They're much more aware of themselves, their surroundings. They have skills that just may be very simplistic to some, but are just totally amazing, whether it's their ability to craft or their ability to make music or whatever their skill is. It's like they have these skills that society has lost. And so anyway, I'm going to link you to this post because there's actually quite a few post within the one, a couple of different articles that speaks about the importance of hair. And biblically speaking, we know about Samson and Delilah, right? Samson lost his strength when his hair was cut. There have been others throughout history. And so this is the endeavor I'm on. When you find out what hair does in relation to the body, helping you absorb vitamin D and calcium, you know, how it shields you from certain things and helps your awareness of certain things. We've just been lied to and made to think so many things in society, and I am determined that I will rise above that. So anyway, I'm going to link you to this. I'm really not in the mood to read, folks. I've put so much time into my activism that I just, I'm burnt out from it. I really am. And now I think it's time for me to change my direction and go along on a path that actually does more to help people face to face. So I'll still be doing what I do for a while, especially while my kids are still in the house, but they're nearing adulthood. In a few years, they're going to be able to fly on their own, and all they will need is a way to contact me and know that I'm there to still support them. But they won't need me to pay their bills. They won't need me to schedule their appointments. And that's just a few short years away. And then I can start on the things that are dear to me other than my children. So anyway, I'm going to link you to this. I hope you guys will read this information and really get a grip on how relative hair is to your inner well-being. It's very relative. I believe that it is. And there's information out there that says your government hid this from you. That they made the trends, they endorsed the trends that would take away every ability you have to think for yourself. And we know that's true. We absolutely know it's true. I could go on. There's so many things. Hair isn't the only one. But if we could start getting back some of what we were deceived out of, then maybe as individuals, we could rise above and achieve, well, what it is everybody hopes to achieve, right? Eternal life in some way, peace, dignity, all those things are lost. So anyway, the link to the post will be below. I'll be posting pictures, you know, of the hair and beard on Twitter, Facebook for a while, just so you guys know that I am not cutting my hair. And if any of you decide to take the same routine, communicate with me. Let me know what changes you see as far as your awareness, your energy levels, any of those things. From what I'm reading, you are going to see a major difference. So I hope this helps some of you achieve something that has been stolen from you. Much love. Many thanks.